Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to yet another Celebrity Journey program supported by UNAIDS. Your host is Moses Supercharger. In the studios, ladies and gentlemen, this evening we are privileged and honored to host one of the youngest HIV advocates in Uganda, and he's called Simon Bukenya. You are most welcome.
Thank you, Super. I'm Simon Peter Bukenya. I'm an HIV activist and advocate who has lived with HIV for the past 30 years.
Past 30 years?
Yes.
And how old are you?
I'm now 32. In December, I'm making 32 years. Mm. But my journey, I realized that I'm HIV positive when I was around 13 years.
13 years?
Yes.
So how did you get the HIV virus, Simon, if I may ask?
Oh yeah, it was a mother to child transmission, because I was when I was growing up, I used to fall sick, and the parents by then couldn't open up. Yeah. To tell the kids that they are HIV positive. But it was my grandmother who saw me like falling sick every now and then. Mm-hmm. And then she talked to me and told me that, how do you see if we go for an HIV test? Mm-hmm. So when we went, it was a hard journey. Mm. For her to convince me, but later on, to cut the story short, yeah, she convinced me, and then we went for the HIV testing at USC in Jinja. Mm. That's when I realized that I was HIV positive at 13 years.
At 13 years?
Yes.
So you have taken medications for more than 15 years.
Very true.
And you're looking nice.
Yes.
What are the challenges? Now you represent over 150 Ugandans who are young persons living with HIV.
True.
We are interested in knowing the challenges of young persons. What are some of the challenges that you face as a person living with HIV?
Some of the challenges that I encountered when I was still in that age. One, it was stigma. Second, the pill burden when you're growing up. Yeah. And then another challenge is about how you take the drugs when you in a school. Mm. Especially, I used to be in a boarding section.
Oh, you were in a boarding school.
And in a boarding section, you know, the beds.
Yeah.
You three on the bed, on the deca, and then pulling out your drugs and then you take them, it was a challenge. And in fact, it brought me some drug resistance. Yeah. Where they had to switch me to second line. Oh. So I came like that, not until when I realized, after switching to second line, I realized that I need my life, after realizing that this is the journey that I have to walk throughout all my life. Mm. So that's when I even came out to say that I'm HIV positive. Mm. To help other young people in schools. Mm. And in fact, in my former school, my secondary school, I left a club for HIV people that they used to walk through my path.
Wow, wow, yes. Wow, that's amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, this time around, we are hosting Simon. He's one of the most tantalizing young advocates we have in the country. He's living with HIV. He was born with HIV, and now he's 32 years. Simon, are you married?
Right now, I'm not married.
Are you searching?
Of course, I am searching. Yeah. And ready to have someone who's going to be with me. Mm-hmm. But I had some relationship where I even have my kid, and it did not work out very well. But it was not because of being HIV positive. Mm. Because I'm open living with HIV, and
whoever comes to you, I tell you, you have the virus.
HIV positive. Before I even tell you that, you know what, I would like to marry you. Mm. The first thing that I'm impressed in you, but I'm HIV positive. Can we walk the journey of being together?
If no, get out of my way. Yes. I love that. The reason why I asked you,
yes,
there is a challenge that young people normally face, especially those who are living with HIV.
True.
When the partners get to know that they're actually positive, the partners who are negative, they run away.
True.
So how do you advise young persons who go through this problem?
My advice to the young people is to remain calm and live openly. Once you tell someone that you're HIV positive, but you're in love with that person, if he's in love with you and there is pure love, they will stay. will stay.
Wow,
but once you live in fear and you don't open up, once someone discovers it, he's going to live with a broken heart.
Yeah.
The trustworthy will be distorted, and your relationship is going also to cease. So once you open up, you're keeping your relationship together, and that person will stay knowing that you take care and caution of his or her life.
Exactly. That's so amazing, Simon. Now, the last question which I want to pose to you.
Yep.
There is a saying, and there is a possibility to end HIV by 2030. Actually, UNAID said,
yes,
we can end AIDS by 2030. Now, you as a person who is living with HIV, an advocate and a Ugandan who really loves his country, what is it that Uganda has to do to end AIDS by 2030?
One of the priority thing, thank you for that question, is one, the treatment literacy in our communities has to sink right from the ground, right from the, let me use this word, of the mwananchi obomuntu wa wansi. It has to think down so that people get to understand that a person who is living with HIV, once is put on treatment and is undetected, that is when we are going to reduce the new infections in the country to end AIDS by 2030. Another thing is the community perception about HIV. There is a lot of science, a lot of innovations, a lot of methods of preventing HIV and treating HIV.
Yeah.
We are at the load of discovering the cure, but we cannot have that load when we still have stigma in the communities. The way how people in the community who are negative see the people who are living with HIV. So that problem, because to get a person being infected must be a person who is not really taking his medicines or her medicines well to infect another person. So if we get out of that stigma and then embrace these people and empower them, you embrace people who are living with HIV to take their medicines adequately, we are going to end these new infections, and then we are at the load of ending AIDS by 2030.
Wow, Simon has nailed it. That brings us to the end of this program, The Celebrity Journey. The host have been Moses Supercharge, and the guest has been Simon Bukenya.